Buffalo wings are a staple of the tailgating circuit. Burnt ends are one of the high holies of barbecue. Put them together and you get the apotheosis of brisket with enough firepower to light up your mouth like a July 4th sky. Burnt ends are traditionally made with the brisket point, that is the fatty upper section of the brisket, sometimes called the deckle. Start by trimming off any excess fat, but leaving nonetheless at least a quarter of an inch of fat to keep the brisket moist during cooking. The idea is to give your brisket point an aerodynamic shape so it smokes more evenly. Next step, of course, is to make a rub. It consists of equal parts salt, freshly ground black pepper, onion powder, and garlic powder for aroma, and Turkish oregano for spice. And season the bottom of the brisket point first. Be sure and get the edges. Then turn your brisket over and season the top of the brisket point the same way. To smoke the burnt ends, I'm using a Peak Green Mountain pellet grill. I'll open the lid of the hopper, add hardwood pellets. I think oak goes particularly well with brisket. Then close the hopper, latch it closed, place the brisket point fat side up in the pellet grill, close the lid, and smoke the brisket point at 250 degrees for 1 hour. Meanwhile, prepare the red wine spray. Start by adding equal parts dry red wine and red wine vinegar. After 1 hour, open the pellet grill. You can see the brisket has taken on some color. Spray it with your red wine vinegar mixture. Close the pellet grill. Continue smoking the point for 4 hours, spraying every 45 minutes. It's been 4 hours. Our brisket point is mostly cooked. So the next step is to place it on 2 sheets of foil. Place another 2 sheets of foil on top and tightly enclose the brisket in foil. Whoops, forgot one thing. I'm gonna just spray it one more time with our red wine mixture. Then we'll come over here. The brisket goes back in the smoker for another 2 hours. The idea here, we've sealed in the juices. The brisket now, at this point, will steam. It will become very tender. Back in the smoker. Well, 2 hours have passed. That makes 6 hours in all. So the brisket point should be ready, but I like to check the internal temperature. You're looking for about 200 and 205, 199.9, close enough. Remember, the brisket point will continue cooking. Now you could serve the brisket right away, but it will be even more succulent if you rest it for an hour in an insulated cooler. Meanwhile, I'll show you how to make the buffalo hot sauce. It starts with butter, which you'll melt in a skillet. Traditional buffalo wing sauce contains butter and hot sauce. I like to notch up the heat by adding thinly sliced jalapeno chilies and cilantro for an aromatic touch. So fry the chilies and cilantro until they begin to brown. Now add your favorite hot sauce. Bring this mixture to a boil, and that's all there is to your buffalo hot sauce. Here's the brisket point after 1 hour of resting. That is where you want to be. So I'll transfer it to the cutting board. Now, cut the brisket point into 1-inch cubes. So we'll cut this way first. Oh boy, look at that smoke ring. In the beginning, burnt ends were just that, the charred pieces that were deemed too burnt to sell to paying customers. So restaurants like Arthur Bryant's in Kansas City would give them away to people in the waiting line. Over time, burnt ends have morphed into a dish in their own right. Transfer the brisket to a skillet. Now add the jalapeno hellfire. Pour it over the brisket. All those nice jalapeno chilies. Take a taste. Smoky, crusty, luscious, meltingly tender, with enough heat to make you sit up and take notice. Buffalo brisket burnt ends. Consider it a marriage of two tailgating classics.